Hey G. So this question goes to about 1999 or 2000, and Betty had taken a computer-generated image of this to work with her, and somebody had put the fear of the internet into her, saying that we put that out there without a patent, it'll be gone, and blah blah blah. So she comes home pretty upset, and I didn't really want to get into patents at all because I thought, oh, scam, lawyers, bullshit. Anyway, I thought, well, we'll put the question to the Ching. That was my great idea. That'll save me the grief. I was sure it wasn't gonna, lead me down that path. So the question was, please advise regarding a protection of the invention. So we pulled 50 to 55. 50 is the cauldron, and 55 is abundance. And this was the first question regarding the invention. All right, 50, the cauldron, Ting, the cauldron, wood under fire. The six lines construct the image of the Ting, the cauldron. At the bottom are the legs, over them the belly, then come the ears. Handles at the top, they're carrying rings. At the same time, it would suggest the idea of nourishment. The Ting cast of bronze was the vessel that held the cooked viands in the temple of the ancestors and at banquets. The head of the family served the food from the Ting into the bowls of the guests. The well likewise has a secondary meaning of giving nourishment, but rather more in relation to the people. The Ting as a utensil or appliance pertaining to a refined civilization suggests the fostering and nourishing of able men, which redounded to the benefit of the state. Is hexagram and the well the only two in the Book of Changes that represent concrete man-made objects? Yet too, the thought has its abstract connotation. Sun below is wood and wind, Li above is flame. Thus together they stand for the flame kindled by wood and wind, which likewise suggests the idea of preparing food. So, couple of things in that first line, or first paragraph. Right, so here's an image of a Ting or a cauldron, legs, belly. I would assume the handles are there in the side and the carrying rings at the top. And when we look at what we've got legs, belly. There's handles there. I've used them as handles anyway. And here you go again, handles. Belly, another system. And then here, this one is actually carried. It's a carousel. Like so. So you can see there are. What passes for carrying rings? So check, 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 check. I could find all of those things. It's a man-made object, of course. The food is served out of at the banquets. And offerings. Did we get the offerings? Maybe not. The judgment, the cauldron, supreme success, good fortune. Supreme good fortune, success. While the well relates to the social foundation of our life, and this foundation is likened to the water that serves to nourish growing wood, the present hexagram refers to the cultural superstructure of society. Here it is the wood that serves as nourishment for the flame, the spirit. All that is visible must grow beyond itself, extend into the realm of the invisible. Thereby it receives its true consecration and clarity and takes firm root in the cosmic order. Here we see civilization as it reaches its culmination in religion. The ting serves in offering sacrifice to God. The highest earthly values must be sacrificed to the divine, but the truly divine does not manifest itself apart from man. The supreme revelation of God appears in prophets and holy men. To venerate them is true veneration of God. The will of God is revealed through them. Should be accepted in humility. This brings inner enlightenment and true understanding of the world. This leads to great good fortune and success. So inner enlightenment is always kind of a tongue-in-cheek one around here. As in, got the light inside, growing indoors. The highest earthly values. So at the time, in 1999, I would argue the highest earthly values were cannabis seeds that were selling for as much as $50 per seed. So if you weigh that up, by the time you get to grams and ounces, it crushes gold or other things that were, you know, high value. And how things are offered to the deities in the cauldron, expensive effigies of things. You know, there's a whole industry that makes fake money and paper Maseratis and all this kind of stuff, and they're burnt in the cauldron, and the smoke travels up to the heavens. Now, if you're thinking about cannabis, and of course, the smoke is being burnt and rising up into the heavens. So I thought that was rather amusing, and it was all covered. And where are we here? So, cosmic order. Kind of looks a bit like the garden, I would have to say. The light in the middle of the rotation. And then another cauldron shot. Bit different, that one. But here's the one, you know, the temple cauldron. Now, it's hard to tell, of course, what's being burnt in there when you've got such fire, but certainly that's, you know, I've talked to people that have, you know, burnt money and burnt things to go up to the ancestors and the relatives and whatnot that have made their transition. The image, fire over wood, the image of the cauldron, thus the spirit man consolidates his fate by making his position correct. The fate of fire depends on wood. As long as there is wood below, the fire burns above. It is the same in human life. There is in man likewise a fate that lends power to his life, and if he succeeds in assigning the right place to life and to fate, thus bringing the two into harmony, he puts his fate on a firm footing. These words contain hints about the fostering of life as handed on by old traditions, secret teachings of Chinese yoga. So my understanding of Chinese yoga is another word for Tai Chi. And I developed this because of my exposure to Tai Chi teachings and the Book of Changes. And this reminds me of the inner Taoist alchemy for the posturing. And basically, you're carrying, in the book teaching Tai Chi, before it starts teaching you, it describes it as a load-bearing posture. So to think of the idea of the hips being a bowl, and you're hanging from the top of your head like you've got a ponytail wrapped around the rafters. Or you're balancing something on your head, and you're dropping the hips away from that point of contact. And I had an image. Right, so here we've got, yeah, poor structure, correct structure. You can see the up and down version of this. So if this was, you know, standing with your knees locked, that's sort of what happens. And most people are falling into their steps because the bowl, that is the hips, and you don't see it here, but the guts are usually spilling forward out of that bowl. So you want to balance the guts in the bowl. And that then lights a fire in your thighs to steam the torso. That's the secret Taoist alchemic process. And what should be happening, if you get the posture right, then you get all these energy flows. So pulled three changing lines. Six at the beginning means a ting with legs upturned, furthest removal of stagnating stuff. One takes a kite bite for the sake of a sudden, no blame. If a ting is turned upside down before it's used, no harm is done. On the contrary, this clears it of refuse. The concubine's position is lowly, but because she has a son, she comes to be honored. These two metaphors express the idea that a highly developed civilization, such as that indicated by this hexagram, every person of goodwill can in some way rather succeed. No matter how lowly he may be, provided he is ready to purify himself, he is accepted, attains a station which can prove himself fruitful in accomplishment, and as a result, gains recognition. So, our cauldron is turning upside down constantly, and that's one of the constant things of it. That's what the motor's for. And I would say that, you know, we are kind of descriptive in the rest of this. No matter how lowly, I'm nobody. Nine, in the second place, there is food in the ting. My comrades are envious, but they cannot harm me. Good fortune. In a period of advanced culture, it is of the greatest importance that one should achieve something significant. If a man concentrates on such real undertakings, he may indeed experience envy and disfavor, but that is not dangerous, nor he limits himself to his actual achievements. Thus harm can the envious inflict on him. That's been a hard lesson for me, but learning that. Another thing about this, stagnation, removing stagnation. So that's stagnation. There's a hexagram for that. It's number 12. And it kind of represents a type 1. It's got an overhead light, heaven over earth, and heaven is ascending, leaving earth behind in confusion and disorder. So if you lay the lumen chart over top of a flat grow with the light on top, especially a greenhouse model with the light being up, you know, 10 feet up in the air, it's too high to have a growth relationship with the plants. We've covered this before. It's just a photoperiod relationship annoying the plants. So then, so our cauldron is turning upside down to remove that archetype. Right at the top, a ting has rings of jade, great good fortune. You know this one, nothing that would not act further. In a preceding line, the carrying rings are described as golden to denote their strength. It is said to be a jade. Jade is notable for its combination of hardness with soft luster. This counsel, in relation to the man who is open to it, works greatly to his advantage. Here the counsel is described in relation to the sage who imparts it. In imparting it, he will be mild and pure like precious jade. Thus the work finds favor in the eyes of deity, who dispenses great good fortune and becomes pleasing to men, wherefore all goes well. That takes us to 55, abundance, fullness. Above, Chen, the arousing thunder. Below, Li, the clinging fire. Chen is movement, Li is flame, whose attribute is clarity. Clarity within, movement without. This produces greatness and abundance. Hexagram pitches a period of advanced civilization. However, the fact that development has reached a peak suggests this extraordinary condition of abundance cannot be maintained permanently. Well, this is a universal archetype of abundance, and the garden is this. The garden conforms to this, and also the cosmic order. Fire inside movement. You can see the spiraling arms there, and the movement, and definitely the concentrated light on the inside. The same thing you get with the garden. You don't see the movement as much compared to the galaxy, but that would have to qualify, I believe, for your cosmic order and your archetype of abundance. Let's continue on. The judgment, abundance, has success. The king attains abundance. Be not sad. Be like the sun at midday. It is not given to every mortal to bring about a time of outstanding greatness and abundance. Only a born ruler of men is able to do it, because his will is directed to what is great. Such a time of abundance is usually brief. Therefore, a sage might well feel sad in view of the decline that must follow, but such sadness does not benefit him. Only a man who is inwardly free of sorrow and care can lead in a time of abundance. He must be like the sun at midday, illuminating and gladdening everything under heaven. The image, both thunder and lightning, come in the image of abundance. Thus, the superior man decides lawsuits and carries out punishments. This hexagram has a certain connection with She-Hulk biting through. Number 21, in which thunder and lightning appear together but in reverse order. In biting through, laws are laid down. Here they are applied and enforced. Clarity within makes it possible to investigate the facts exactly, and shock without ensures a strict and precise carrying out of punishments. So here we are, lawsuits. And the question was, how do we protect the invention, patents, etc.? It was actually how it read originally. So the only way to have standing in a lawsuit would be to have intellectual property rights. So this thing, you know, really, we're doing such a basic thing, an elemental thing, an elemental correction, I would say, that we're able to basically take very, very face value reads with this. And you know, that's the reality of where we are with this whole thing, which is pretty amazing. Anyway, I will follow up with another one shortly.